Right, it's the middle of the British summer, so it started raining again. So this is the location of the post-cat lambda sensor, sitting between the air filter box and the ECU. I soaked these in a bit of WD-40 and loosened them off the other night. So these are just on finger tight. Be nice if everything came off cars as easily as this. Right, here we go. Nope. Don't think so. That's just the socket flexing. Right, it's going to need heat. There's no way that's going to come off. I think, to be honest, that's kind of well and truly. Well, here we have the front lambda sensor. There we go. That one's a lot easier to get. There's a lot of oil underneath this engine. It'd be really good to work out where this has come from. And looks like I've got signs of a very slight water leak there as well. You can see a drip. It is a bit nasty under here. This is rather handy. It looks like I've got a stainless steel manifold on here. Okay, that was a messy couple of hours, as you can see by my face. Right, we'll have a look at this.
Time of the day. It's been quite a while.
Pushing up tight. We'll be right back. getting all those bolts out wasn't particularly easy. All six of them needed cutting. Three of them then came out with mole grips. The other three needed drilling out. And actually two of them, what I've had to do is I've had to drill the holes oversized, tap them out, and obviously I'm going to end up using oversized bolts. Next job, find some metal, reinforce the heat shield, and paint myself up a couple of those brackets. To convert it back on and torqued up to 50 newton meters, and now for the exciting bit, I get to fit my shiny, fantastic new stainless steel back box.